today, in a special and an exclusive interview, we are going to talk to one of the top 10 spinners of India. Right now, I'm in front of Shri Ashish Bhai Shah. He is the Managing Director of Aarvee Denims and Exports Limited. Aarvee Denim is into spinning from 6 to 30 count. It's into weaving, it's into processing and garmenting. So there's a good amount of forward integration within the company, and the company has earned the goodwill in India and abroad. Ashish Bhai, can you start?
Yeah.
So the first question to you would be, how was the current season in general for Indian cotton spinners?
So basically this season cotton prices were quite high, internationally as well as in the domestic market.
Okay.
So, and as far as our company, that is Aarvee Denims, is concerned, in last one and a half years, 40% of denim production has gone up in India. So there is
40%.
That is the oversupply situation in denim.
Right.
And with the high cotton prices, which is the basic raw material for our company, our top line has been affected drastically. Last year we were at around 40 crores of profit. This year we are at 4 crores of profit.
Oh,
so that is how the top line has been affected. And that is mainly because of the high cotton prices and oversupply situation in the denim market.
How do you normally judge the market trend during the cotton season? Because every day you have to spin something, you have to weave, you have to process. So what are the factors that determine your...
Usually we buy cotton in bulk, and we usually keep stock of around 2 months to 3 months.
Stock of 2 to 3 months.
2 to 3 months of cotton. When there is high season, when the supplies are at peak, we keep stocks of around 5 weeks, 5 to 6 weeks.
Okay.
And when the prices are high and when the supplies are low, we keep the stock of around 1.5 to 2 months.
Okay.
So that is how we plan our cotton buy.
Next would be like, whom do you rely on for the cotton crop estimates? Like there is CCI, there is Cotton Association of India, Agriculture Ministry, USDA, ICAC.
I think USDA is giving more pronounced figures as far as even Indian cotton market is concerned. But we get feedback from each zones wherein our suppliers tell us that in Gujarat we'll get so much so of crop this year, and our suppliers will aggregate all these zones and will give us the figures, and those figures are more or less realistic.
What is your idea about the trend in the new season, which starts on October?
See, basically I feel that cotton market will ease out considerably, I think it should go down to 33,000-34,000 levels. If CCI or government agencies doesn't enter, then there will be a free fall. Because the crop estimates, what we see, the Indian crop estimates as well as US crop estimates, and the carryover stocks and all, then this is the estimate what I feel is going to happen in coming season.
Ashish Bhai, the most important question now is, like we have been discussing, there is a trust deficit in the market. Dealers feel that the mills do not understand their problems, or they do not know whom to trust. Similarly, it is the exporters. They say the dealers are at fault, the dealers say the exporters knowingly did what they did this year. So now from here on, like a person like you who's already earned a good brand name, a good market position, so how do you safeguard your company in this situation?
See, we pick our suppliers and we are very choosy in that. If we have one or couple of problems in one season with one supplier, we will not deal with them again. And even suppliers know how our system works, and how our laboratory works, or what is our payment system, and whatever we say that we pay in 30 days, we are going to
honor
our commitment. So we are lucky that we are getting good suppliers, and they have trust in us and we have trust in them. And with the years of business, since last 20-25 years we are doing business with them, so we have developed that trust between supplier and the buyer. So I think that should be the case with everybody.
Thank you, Ashish bhai. Your views are most significant to the industry, and we really thank you for being part of this interview.